Good morning all of you. This is my third video. In this video, we are going to discuss about the non-conventional sources of energy. About the conventional sources of energy, I already discussed in my video 1, that means part 1 and part 2. If you haven't gone through that video, please go through that video and subscribe our channel Nirja Education. In this video, we are going to discuss about the non-conventional sources. Conventional, what do you mean by conventional? Already we discussed that one. That means that we are traditionally using, that is conventional sources of energy. Now we are discussing about this non-conventional sources of energy. That means that we are using from recently. So that type of sources are known as non-conventional sources of energy. In this non-conventional sources of energy, the first one is solar energy, then wave energy, tidal energy, ocean thermal energy and geothermal energy. And one more thing is there, that is nuclear energy. All these are non-conventional sources of energy. Solar energy, wave energy, tidal energy, ocean thermal energy, geothermal energy and nuclear energy. All these energies are renewable energies. That is the one of the advantages of this energy. That means all these are renewable energies and these all energies are eco-friendly. This does not cause any environmental pollution. So, all these are environmental friendly. First, we will go to the solar energy. In solar energy, what happens is we are making use of the energy from the sun. The energy from the sun, the solar energy is converting into electrical energy. In solar energy here, the solar energy is converting into electric energy. For this, we are using solar cells. For this, we are using this solar cell. Solar cell is made up of silicon. And sometimes we are using silver also. Silicon is mostly used to make this solar cell. Actually, one of the disadvantages of this solar cell is that because silicon is so expensive, so this is the one of the disadvantages of this solar cell, that we make this solar energy or solar energy panel, it is very expensive because the silicon is very expensive here. Now, when two or three more solar cells are connected in series, that is known as solar panels. Two or three solar cells are connected in series, that is known as solar panel. So, solar energy, this is using converting solar energy into electrical energy. The solar panels or solar cells, they are trapping solar energy and converting it into electrical energy. Actually, this silicon is a semiconductor. This silicon is a semiconductor. What do you mean by semiconductor? Because at normal temperature, it does not conduct electricity. At normal temperature, this silicon does not conduct electricity. When it traps solar energy, it is getting more energy, that means more heat, then it becomes a conductor. Then silicon becomes a conductor and it will start conducting electricity. That is why we are using this silicon in solar panels. Already I told the advantages, that it is eco-friendly, and disadvantage also I told, because the one is that silicon, it is very expensive, and the another one is that because it depends the weather. If it is cloudy day or rainy day, we can't get enough solar energy. So that is one of the disadvantage of this solar cell or solar panels. Next, we are going to the next one, that is wave energy. Wave energy is making use of the kinetic energy of the waves. Kinetic energy of the waves. This wave energy, we are making use of the kinetic energy of the waves. This almost, these panels are wave energy construction. Power plants are located near to the seashore. Due to the kinetic energy, that means due to the movement of the waves, what will happen? The turbine will start rotating, and the what happens, you know that after that, due to the rotation of this turbine, the generator will start rotating and the electricity is produced here. So we are making use of the kinetic energy of the waves here. These power plants are situated near the seashore to make use of the kinetic energy of the waves. Here also this will rotate the turbines, and the turbine will rotate the generator, and the electricity is produced here. The next one is tidal energy. Tide, how these tides are causing? It is caused due to the gravitational pull of the moon. Tides are causing due to the gravitational pull of the moon. That is why the tides are happening. And due to the tides, what will happen? Actually, these power plants are situated, the turbines are situated under the water. Under the water, the turbines are situated. When tides comes and go back, what will happen? The turbine will start rotating. When the tides comes and go back, the turbine will start rotating, and it will make the generator associated with the turbine to rotate, and electricity is produced. In here, wave energy, the power plants are located near the seashore, and here under the water it is situated. The turbines are situated under the water. Next, we are going to the ocean thermal energy. Ocean thermal energy, in this one we are making use of the temperature difference between the surface water and deeper inside the sea. This temperature difference we are making use here. The temperature difference should be 20 degrees Celsius, then only we can utilize this ocean thermal energy. Already you know that the surface water will be more hot when we are comparing to the water inside the sea. So in this figure you can see that one, and the ammonia is pumped into the evaporator. Here this is the evaporator, and using the surface water will be hot, that means it will be 25 degrees Celsius. Here you can see almost 25 degrees Celsius, and we are making use of this surface water. And using this surface water we are boiling this ammonia. And the ammonia will start evaporating, and this steam will be passed to the turbine. And this steam will make the turbine to rotate. The same principle is happening here also. After that, the steam will make the turbine to rotate, and the turbine will make the generator associated to it to rotate, and electricity will be produced here. I will explain one more. Here ammonia will be there, and ammonia will be pumped into the evaporator. Using this surface water, we will evaporate this ammonia. And the ammonia will start evaporating, and this steam will be passed into the turbine. The turbine will start rotating, and due to the rotation of the turbine, the generator will start rotating, and electricity is produced there. And you can see one condenser also. Why we are using this condenser? This steam will again pass into the condenser, and using the water inside the deep inside the ocean, what we will do? We will condense this ammonia. We will condense this steam of the ammonia, and again it will change into the liquid form, and we can make use of it again. That means this cycle will go on. Using this condenser for condensing, we are making use of the water from the deep inside the sea, and using this water we will condense the ammonia, and it will change into the liquid form. Again we can use the liquid ammonia, and this will again pump into the evaporator. That means this cycle will go on. Next, the question is that why we are using ammonia here? This is the one of the important question in board exam. Why we are using ammonia? The answer is that it is volatile. What do you mean by volatile? It can be evaporated easily. Even normal room temperature also it will be evaporated. That is why we are using ammonia. Otherwise, in almost all the cases, we can use the water also. But here, we can't use the water because using this surface water, we can't boil the water. That is why we are using ammonia. So, the boiling point and melting point of ammonia is very low. We can use this condensation process also. That is also happening easily. So, that is why we are using ammonia here. It is very volatile. And the second one is that is the reason for why we are using ammonia. And to get the ocean thermal energy sufficiently, the temperature difference should be 20 degrees Celsius. The temperature difference between the surface water and the water inside the sea should be 20 degrees Celsius. Then only we can utilize this ocean thermal energy. I hope all of you have understood how this ocean thermal power plants are working. Now we are going to the next one, that is geothermal power plants. Next we are going to discuss geothermal energy. Geothermal energy, what do you mean by geo? Geo means earth. So we are using this energy from the earth. You know that larva is there inside the earth. So in some cases, in ecological reason or maybe in some cases, what will happen? This larva will come out and it will be trapped inside the rocks. Then these rocks becomes very hot. This is known as hot spot. These hot rocks are known as hot spot. When underground water passes through this hot spot, what will happen? The water will start boiling. That means the steam will come out. We can make use of this steam. Through the pipe, you can utilize this steam, and using this steam, we can rotate the turbines. Again, you know the turbines, what will happen after the rotation? When the turbine rotates, the generator associated with it also rotates and electricity is produced. That this is how we are getting geothermal energy. Due to some ecological reason, what will happen? The larva will come out and it will be trapped in the rocks. These rocks are known as hot spot. When the underground water passes through this hot spot, it will start boiling. We can make use of these steams. Using this steam, we can rotate these turbines. When the turbine rotates, the generator associated with this turbine will rotate and electricity is produced here. The disadvantage is that we can't get everywhere this hot spot. So that is the one of the disadvantage of this geothermal energy. Next, we are moving to the next source of energy, that is nuclear energy. Next, we are moving to nuclear energy. Nuclear energy, we are making use the energy of the nucleus of an atom. You know that already you have learned about the nucleus of an atom. So, two types of processes there, nuclear fission and nuclear fusion. What do you mean by nuclear fission? Nuclear fission means the nucleus of a bigger atom will break down into two smaller atoms. That is known as nuclear fusion. The nucleus of a bigger atom will break down into two smaller atoms. That is known as nuclear fission. During this fission, a tremendous amount of energy is released. We are making use of this energy. And nuclear fusion means when two small atoms, the nucleus of small atoms will combine and form a bigger atom. That is known as nuclear fusion. Fusion means combining, fission means breaking. The breaking of nucleus and the combining of nucleus. So, in these two processes, a tremendous amount of energy is released. We are making use of this energy. We are using this energy to boil the water. In nuclear power plants, actually it is happening. We are using this energy to boil the water, and making use of this steam, we will rotate the turbines, and due to the rotation of the turbines, the generator will rotate and electricity is produced. This is how the nuclear power plants are working. That means the nuclear fission we are using here, due to the energy produced by nuclear fission, the water will start boiling, and this steam we are using to rotate the turbines. And due to the rotation of the turbines, the generator will rotate and the electricity is produced. the one of the disadvantage of this nuclear reactors are it is hazardous to the people, those who are working there, because continuously it is emitting rays. That is the one of the disadvantage of this nuclear power plant. It is hazardous to the environment and it is hazardous to the people, those who are working, because care should be taken, otherwise it is very hazardous to the environment. Thank you.